But thanks everyone for joining Illinois Squash Sunday workouts and yoga. We do live sessions every Sunday and then on YouTube so that you can do them on your own. So I just want to thank you all for coming to your mat. You can have a blanket or a towel or anything that will help give you a little bit more cushion, or just have a mat, whatever feels good for you, and just listen to your body. I know some of us have been shoveling snow or just walking through in this weather, and our bodies can feel a little stiff. So we're going to focus on just creating space in our bodies. And I think this is just a really good theme for, you know, when you're on the squash court or at work, creating space for yourself and for others. So we'll go ahead and get into a comfortable seat. You can have your feet crossed, you can have them out, whatever feels good for you. And put your hands on your thighs, on your knees, and we'll just take a deep breath in and out. Start to settle in, breathing in. You can bring your shoulders up and down. Feel free to close your eyes if that feels comfortable, and down. And we'll start to make little circles with our nose, just going in one direction with your breath at your own pace. And change the direction of your circle. Once you're even on both sides, come back to a neutral, and we'll put our hands onto our shoulders, and we'll bring our elbows to touch. You'll feel a big stretch through your shoulder blades, and then make some circles with your arms. You can come and have your elbows touch if we're close to touching, so that you're just feeling your shoulder blades opening out. Nice and slow here. And then we'll go the other way. So bringing them to touch and then reversing that circle with your elbows. Just starting to warm up here. And if this feels uncomfortable, you can always do this with your hands off, but that really gets the shoulder blades going. And then once you've done both directions, we'll come back to a neutral. Now we'll start coming out onto the mat. So we'll come into a neutral tabletop here. And if you'd like, you can have the pad underneath. You can remove that. Stack your shoulders and your knees right underneath your hips. One of the things for your hands is you can pretend you're twisting open a can or anything. That way you can really activate your arms. And I'll just show you this really quickly. So what I mean is, on the mat, if you're pretending to be opening a can, it'll force your arms to open and really stabilize. So this protects your wrists. Or, you know, just claw the mat, whatever metaphor or visualization works for you. And we'll just do a couple of cat-cows. So breathing in, dropping your belly, and breathing out, arching your back. We'll do this three times at your own pace. Feel free to make circles with your hips and your head, whatever movement feels good for you. And then we'll kick out our left leg and we'll lift up that leg, bringing some energy into that foot. And we will bend the knee so that you can start to feel that hamstring activate, and do a couple of little knee circles. Just waking up your hips and go the other direction.
I'm glad you're not saying, let's do the Laura Massaro.
Yes, definitely lots of hip warming up.
Damon did that for us.
Oh, good. You can keep the legs straight if you like and do little circles in the other direction, trying to stay as stable as possible. If that feels like too much, you can always come back down. And then just rocking back and forth, kind of waking up that calf. Then bring that left foot over to the right side of your mat. And then look over your right shoulder to see your toes. You should feel a nice stretch along the left side of your body. Breathing in, focusing your breath where you want that stretch to go. Nice. And then come back to a neutral. And we'll reach out our right hand as if you're shaking someone's hand and kick that left foot back. Breathing in and crunching the forward. Breathing in and expanding, creating space, and then crunching back to contract. Do this at your own pace. And then once you've done a couple, come back down. We'll lift our left arm up into the air for a little stretch. And then you'll bring your left arm through the space you created. And you can drop your hand face up, the palm up, and have that little stretch in your shoulder blade. So we're on our left ear, on our left shoulder. Try and bump your hips to the left, and you'll feel that stretch all along your left side body. If you'd like, you can bring your right arm out straight. You can bring it back for a bind. Whatever spot feels good for you. Breathing in and out. We'll be here for two more breaths. And then push into your right hand and come out of that twist. We'll do the little counter stretch, bringing our left arm into the air. And now we'll switch sides. Do a little cat-cow, a little shoulder roll to start to reset, and then we'll kick our right foot back. We'll bring it up into the air. We'll bend that knee and do a couple little hip circles. Trying to keep as stable as possible, clawing into the mat. Switch the direction of your circle. And then bring your foot out straight again. Do a couple little circles here as well. Switch the direction. And at any time you can bring it back down, just rock back and forth to kind of warm up that calf. And then we'll lift that right foot up and bring it over to the left side of our mat. It can even come off the mat, right? And then look over your left shoulder to see your foot. And feel that stretch all along your right side body. Breathing in and out where you want to focus that stretch. And then come back to a neutral tabletop. We'll bring that right foot up into the air and we'll extend our left arm this time. Breathing in and creating space. Breathing out and crunching. Breathing in, kicking that foot back, reaching that arm forward, and then on the exhale, creating a circle with your body. Straight out and contract. Nice. And now we'll come back to that neutral tabletop, reach your right arm up into the air, and then we'll thread the needle on the other side, bringing your right shoulder to the mat, your right arm is coming under. Keeping your hips pushed over to the right so you feel that stretch along the right side. And putting the left hand wherever feels good for support. You can have it in a bind, out straight. Play around with the position until you feel stable. And we'll be here for two more breaths. Nice. And then we'll push into our left arm and come out of the twist with a little counter stretch. We'll come back into a neutral tabletop. Do a little shoulder shrugs, a little hip circles. And now we'll come into our downward dog.
I like to come into it from a levitated table by lifting my knees up, really making sure I have a good foundation, breathing in, and then when I breathe out, I push my hips up into the air. Just walk our dog. Pushing evenly into our hands and our feet. You can bend your knees generously, breathing in and out, letting your belly come close to your legs. And then when you straighten, you can feel that space again. And we'll bend our right leg and straighten our left, and we'll kick that right leg up. You'll bend the knee again, and then you can open up your hips. Do some little circles with your ankle. You can do circles with the knee. Go in both directions. And then come back to a square hip. Get that right foot up again. Breathe in, and on the exhale, come through for a lunge. And then you can drop that back knee down if that feels good for you. Make sure you set yourself up so that your knee is right on top of your ankle. Breathe in. You can puff up your chest. My hands, you know, can be on the floor, on a block. You know, get any props that you like here. We'll start to move our right foot out towards the right side of our mat for a lizard pose. So it's just this lunge, but with my foot a little bit further towards the right side, and my hand will come onto the inside of my foot. So both of my hands are on the inside of that foot. And you can do a little bend of the arms to feel that right through your hip here. We'll be here for a couple of breaths. So get yourself set up. You can come down further if you've got that flexion, or you can be up on a block. Breathing in and out. We'll be here for a couple more breaths. Nice. And then we'll bring our right foot back in between our hands, so our hands are framing it. We'll breathe in, and you can bring your hands to your hips if you'd like, and come up by pushing into that right foot. So now we're just in our lunge here. You can have your hands on your hips. Squeeze those legs together as if you're trying to bring them together, and that'll really activate and help you grow in this position. Breathing in. If you'd like, you can look up. You can bring your hands up for a little bit more balance. Cactus your arms if you like, or stay on your hips if that's a little bit more accessible. And we'll bring our left elbow towards the outside of our right knee for a little twist. You can bring your hands into prayer. If you'd like to challenge yourself, you can come off of that back leg and just try and bring your prayer hands to the center of your chest, looking up if you like. Any arm variation is fine here. Just making sure you're opening towards that side wall. Breathing in. And on the exhale, with control, coming back down, we'll bring our back leg back to the mat. Breathing in. And on the exhale, bringing your hips back for that little counter stretch by straightening your right leg. Flex that right foot and you'll really feel your hamstring light up. You can rock that foot a little bit. Breathe in and melt as far as you'd like. And then we'll bring our foot back down, bend that right leg. We'll bring our left leg back up into the air and come back into a plank position. From your plank, breathe in, set yourself up, pushing your heels back, shining the back of your chest towards the sky. Breathing in, we'll rock forward and back a couple times, and then we'll meet on with our bellies on the mat. So breathe in and slowly come down to the mat. You can rock your head on the mat, Bring your hands underneath your shoulders with almost no weight in your hands. Come up into a little cobra, tucking your chin so you're keeping your neck nice and straight. Breathing in and coming back down. We'll do that one more time. Breathing in and out. Tuck your chin, and on your next inhale, come up for that little back bend. Almost no weight in your hands. And back down. Nice. We'll tuck our toes, activating our feet. Our quads are almost off the mat. Your hands are right underneath your shoulders. Breathe in, firm up your belly, and then push away the mat. Back down to our plank. And at any time, you can always bend your knees. You know, come into these positions if what is accessible to you. Breathing in, and on your exhale, we'll come into downward dog. We'll do that on the other side. Walk your dog out. See how your right side feels in comparison to your left. Breathing in and out. We'll bend our left leg this time, keeping our right leg straight. We'll kick that left leg up into the air. We can bend the knee, open the hips, do some little hip and foot circles. Keeping our hands with equal weight. And then we'll straighten our hips again, breathing in, straightening that left leg, and then bending it and coming through for a lunge. You can bend that back leg, coming down onto the mat, setting yourself up so that your front knee is right over your ankles. You don't want to be too far forward. Setting yourself up there with a good foundation. Breathing in and out. And now we'll bring that left foot over towards the left side of our mat, bringing our left hand onto the inside of that foot. Breathing in and out in this lizard pose. And get any props, blocks, or if you'd like to come down further. Breathing in and out. We'll be here for a couple of breaths. It's a new dawn. It's a new day. It's a new life for me. It's a new dawn. It's a new day. It's a new life for me. Nice. Then you can move your props, bring your left foot back in between both of your legs, both of your hands, I mean. Breathing in, and you can bring your hands to your hips. And then on your exhale, coming up. And really actively using both of those legs to squeeze in, and then you can rise up. You should feel a lot of activation in your left hip as well as in your front of your right leg. Breathing in, you can bring your hands up into the air if you'd like. Cactus in round. Breathing in, or just keeping them on your hips. Making sure your hips are square to the front of your mat. And then we'll bring our right arm, the outside of our elbow, to the outside of the left leg. We'll do that prayer twist on the other side. Feel free to curl the toes and lift out if you'd like to challenge your balance, or keeping that foot down. Nice. And then coming out of that twist with control, you can come back facing forward. Breathing in and out. And you'll bring your hands back down towards the mat, and you'll straighten that left foot for that nice little counter stretch, flexing your toes. You can wiggle here a little bit, pushing the hips back. And then we'll crawl back forward, bringing our foot back down onto the mat, and we'll come back up on our right leg and come into our plank. However you'd like to come into it, feel free to come to your knees. We'll be in this plank for 3 breaths. 1, 2, and 3. Very good. Tipping forward as if you're looking over a cliff. Breathing in and slowly with control coming down to the mat. Great job. You can roll your head side to side for a little neck stretch. You can try coming with your fingertips off the mat this time, or back under your shoulders, whatever feels good. Breathing in, tucking your chin. And on the exhale, coming up. Again, almost no weight in your hands. You can kind of feel how this hand alternative feels for you. And then come back down. We'll try that one more time. Again, almost no weight in your hands. You can bring your elbows up, but a little bit off the mat. And then peeling your head off the floor. Get your chin tucked so that your head, your neck is nice and long. Breathing in and out. We'll come back down to our mat. Our hands will come back underneath our shoulders. Flex your foot and activate your legs so that your quads are coming up. Breathe in, firm up your belly, and push up back to our plank position. Again, you can always have your knees bent, and we'll come back into a down dog on your exhale. Breathing in and out. Pedaling your feet, seeing how you feel after doing both sides. And you'll come, walk your feet up behind your hands for a little forward fold. You can have your feet together or your feet apart, whatever feels good for you. Breathing in and out. You can hold opposite elbows. You can hug behind your knees. Whatever variation feels good for you. We'll be here for a couple breaths. If you had your hands clasped, bring them back down to the mat. We'll come into a flat back. You can push into your shins, your thighs. You can have airplane arms. Breathe in and back down. And we'll slowly roll up one vertebrae at a time, root to rise. So push into all four corners of your feet and then slowly roll up on your mat. Your head is heavy till the last vertebra. Roll your shoulders up and down. You can bring your arms out and then up overhead. Breathing in. Now you can cactus your arms and shine your heart forward for a little back bend. And then return your hands up in the air. Take your right arm and hold your left wrist. And then bump your hips over to the left and tip yourself over to the right for a nice side body stretch. Make sure your shoulders aren't coming up towards your ears. You're really keeping those shoulders down and twisting your heart so you're almost looking at your elbow on the left side. Breathing in and coming back to center. You can cactus your arms again and then breathe in for the arms straight in the air. We'll switch sides. You'll take your left hand onto your right wrist. Breathe in, grow tall, bump your hips to the right as you tip over to the left. Again, keeping space between your shoulders and looking up if you can towards your right elbow. Breathing in and up. And final cactus. We'll bring our hands back up and we'll dive back down, cutting through the mat, back to a forward fold. Breathing in and coming to a flat back again, seeing how your sides feel after that. Back down. Very good. We'll walk our hands back out for a plank. Feeling all of our hips and legs being very strong, our arms. And we'll drop down to our bellies. And then we'll roll onto our backs for that transition. So now we're gonna do some work onto the floor. So get yourself comfortable on the floor. You can breathe in and do a morning stretch. Your feet out towards the end of your mat and your hands up towards the top. Breathing in and out. Bring your right leg bent. Bend your right knee and pull it into your chest. Flex that bottom foot and try and keep it on the mat. If that's difficult, you can bend that left leg as well and keep that left foot into the grounded into the floor. Breathe that right knee into your chest. You can do some little ankle circles in both directions. With your hands on that right knee, do some little circles with your knee in both directions. And we'll come into a figure four, a reclining pigeon. If you prefer to do the pigeon on your belly, feel free to roll back over. I prefer to do this for my back. It's a little bit easier on my knees. But you'll take that right foot and cross the right ankle over the top of your left thigh. You can stay with it here if this feels like enough, or you can levitate so that figure four is now in the air. And you can bring your hands through the opening until you're able to relax into the position. Keep both of the feet active and flexed. We'll be here for two breaths. You can come and add a little rock to this if you'd like a little back massage, or you could say static. We're going to come into a supine twist. You can keep your legs in this position if you'd like, with your right foot flexed crossed over your left thigh, and you can just bring that foot towards the ground for the supine twist. Or if this feels like too much, you can bring your knees together, you can have them crossed, whatever variation you like. Keeping your shoulders on the ground and just having your legs dropped over to the left side. Whatever variation you're in, breathe in and feel free to close your eyes and look in the opposite direction of your legs. A nice way to come out of this is breathing in, and on the exhale, really contracting in your abs and using that contraction to pull yourself back to center. You can breathe in and do that figure four again. We'll uncross the leg, come into a tiny little bow, and then we'll switch sides so you can keep that left leg now bent in. You can bring your right foot down to the mat, keeping it flexed. If it's hard to keep that right leg straight, you can bend it, no problem. Hugging that left knee into your chest, do some little ankle circles. While hugging that knee, use your hands to make little circles with the left leg. And then we'll cross the left foot over the right knee, the right leg, coming only as far as feels good for your body. You can keep the right foot down, or you can start to levitate it. And then if you'd like, you can bring the hands through that opening for the figure four on the other side. Breathing in and out, keeping your shoulders in the direction of the floor. So if you're coming off, kind of back out of the position until you can have your shoulders on the mat. We'll be here for two breaths. Keeping both feet active. And you can bring some movement, rocking a little back and forth for a little back massage. And then we'll come into that supine twist. If you like the leg variation where you were staying in the figure four, you can just rock that left foot print onto the mat. or you can bend both legs, or you can have them crossed, however feels good. Just bring your legs over to the right side, and then your gaze will be out to the left. You can have your hands out in a T, in a cactus, whatever feels good for you. Breathing in and out. And a nice way to come out of this is by breathing in. And then on that exhale, contracting your core so that it curls your legs back up to the sky. You can do that little figure four rocking again. Uncross your legs, come into a tiny little ball. You can bring your nose towards your knees. Any final positions that you want to come into, if you want to do a happy baby, feel free to reach for the outsides of your feet and continue rocking back and forth. But any final positions before we come to Shavasana, feel free to grab a blanket or any, you know, eye pillow props if you'd like. We'll come back into that tiny, tiny little ball, the smallest position you've been in, breathing in, and on your exhale, taking up as much space on the mat as you'd like. You can have your hands up in the air, on your belly. We'll do a little body scan here. Make sure your forehead is nice and relaxed. Close your eyes. Have no tension in your jaw. Maybe even just curling your lips into a little inner smile. Bringing your shoulders heavy onto the mat. If you feel any tension in your lower back or arching, you can also bend your knees and keep your feet as wide as the mat and tip those knees in so that your hips can feel heavy on the mat. Deep breath in. We'll come into our final resting pose, Shavasana. We'll be here for 5 breaths. Feel free to stay here as long as you'd like. I'll guide us out. Start to bring a little movement to your fingertips. You can start to roll your ankles and look side to side for a little neck stretch. You can even bring your hands behind your head for a little head massage. Just waking back up after this. Breathing in. And then on that exhale, using that contraction to roll over onto one side and making a little pillow with your hand underneath your ear. Breathing in. And then pushing up with the strength of both of your arms, coming back into that seated position. Keeping your eyes closed if it's comfortable. Breathing in and out. And to seal that, you can bring your hands to your sternum or your chest. Breathing in, bowing your head. Thank you for coming together for this yoga practice. I really appreciate seeing all your faces. And with that, I'll stop the recording.
Happy legal.